Now let's take a look at the Dropbox feature. This is where you upload your assignments. Your instructor can then download and read the assignment and post feedback to you in the Dropbox. The Dropbox usually has specific locations for each assignment. D2L also has an online quizzing feature. After you click on Quizzes, you'll see the list of quizzes your instructor has entered. Click on the correct quiz. Quizzes are often timed, and you'll see if they are on this page. Once you start the quiz, you'll be able to answer the questions, and it's important to save each answer before you move on to the next question. At the end, there will be a submit button. Once you click on it, you can't change any answers, and it will be graded. Your instructor may also choose to include surveys in your course. Surveys are often used for course evaluations. Now click on the survey you want to complete. Then answer and submit the survey questions, just like you would in quizzes. Let's take a look at the class list feature. You can use the class list feature for each course to learn the names and email contact information of other students in your courses. Click on the name of the person you want to email, and you can write your email from there. Another important feature is the online gradebook. I can see my grade on each assignment as soon as the instructor posts it. D2L quizzes are often graded automatically, so you can see those grades right away. Well, that's my tour of the basics of D2L. There are student quick start guides on the first D2L page if you want to look up any feature for more information. If you'd like to practice moving around a D2L course on your own, find the demonstration course on the online education homepage. When you click on it, you'll see instructions on how to self-enroll. Once you're in the course, explore all the features and you'll see what a typical class looks like.